Hello everyone. Continuing the video series guiding the use of the MetaTrader 5 platform on Exness. In this video, I will guide you on how to use indicators and expert advisors. Through this, I will also guide you through the steps to add more indicators and expert advisors from external sources into this trading platform, to provide you with more tools to assist in determining market trends. In this video, you will also find a very effective method to manage your indicators and expert advisors, helping you to quickly and scientifically install these tools on different product tabs. This is the Exness Market Channel, where we provide the most useful information about trading activities on the Exness platform. We are a leading development partner of Exness. If you're new to Exness Market, make sure to hit the subscribe button to stay updated with our latest videos. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below, and our team will get back to you as soon as possible. You'll find the registration guide and the latest Exness updates in the video description and pinned comment. Besides this channel, you can also visit our Exness Market website to explore more about Exness. To find where indicators and expert advisors are located on this MetaTrader 5 platform, please find the Navigator section. You can select the View section, then find Navigator or press the Ctrl plus N keyboard shortcut. The Indicator section will be neatly organized in a folder like this. And within it, there will be subfolders. In each of these subfolders, there are many different indicators. If you want to use an indicator, you left-click on it and drag it out to the screen. After bringing it to the screen, the indicator's parameter window will appear. You can completely modify these parameters. Of course, if you want to use a specific indicator, you already have reference parameter sets for that indicator, so you will modify them in the corresponding fields. In the Level section, some indicators require modifying or adding information. However, for the Bollinger Bands that I am opening here, this section does not need to be set up. The next section you can edit is the Visualization section. This visualization section will help us hide or show the indicator on different timeframes. You can see that by default it is set to all timeframes. We can uncheck this. Then select the timeframes where we want the indicator to be displayed. If I leave it like this, this indicator will only display on the daily, weekly, and monthly timeframes, while smaller timeframes will not show it. But here, I want it to display on all timeframes, so I will select all timeframes. After editing the indicator's information, we click OK, and the indicator will appear on the screen like this. And based on the correlation between the indicator and the product's price, we can make trading decisions. Some indicators follow the price, like Bollinger Bands. However, some create a new window at the bottom. For example, here, I select an indicator, which is stochastic. I will drag it out to the screen. I can modify its information, then click OK. And you can see here that this indicator creates a window at the bottom, which shrinks our product chart. If I want to expand the product chart, I will move the mouse pointer to the horizontal line. When two opposing arrows appear, I will left-click and drag it downwards. Thus, I have minimized this space. For the indicators that you have brought out to the screen like this, if you want to edit an indicator, you just need to double-click on that indicator. Or if there are many indicators and you are afraid of double-clicking incorrectly, you can right-click on the screen, select Indicator List, and a list of the indicators that we have brought out to the screen will appear here. If you want to edit an indicator, select it and click Properties. If you want to delete that indicator, you will click Delete, or you can also double-click on the indicator to edit its parameters. After editing the indicator's parameters, we click OK, then click Close to close this window. Regarding indicators, there are many different ways to use them. For example, the moving average indicator. Normally, when we drag it out to the screen like this, the calculation of this indicator will be based on the closing price of the candlesticks. You can slightly adjust the period in the upper section. For example, I will set it to 50, then click OK. So, you can see that I have a moving average line running with the price like this. However, now I want to create a moving average line calculated based on the stochastic price, and I will see how the correlation between that moving average line and this stochastic price is to decide to execute trading orders. At that time, I will drag the moving average into this lower window. I release my hand. Then, in the Apply to section, I will click on it and select First Indicators Data. The period section can be slightly adjusted, depending on how we use the parameters. Then, I click OK. I'll change the color of this a bit. I click OK. So, you can see that I draw a different moving average line compared to this one. Right? Now it is in the lower window and it is calculated based on the stochastic. So, based on the correlation between the moving average I just brought out and the stochastic line, I will have entry points. You can observe here, you can adjust this moving average line to get a better set of signals. For using expert advisors here, we will find the expert advisor section below. By default, MetaTrader 5 also provides us with some expert advisors like these. However, we don't know how they work. Therefore, if we want to use them, we also need to put in a lot of effort to understand what's inside them. It's best that we use an expert advisor that we program ourselves or that we get from somewhere else. Then we will use those expert advisors to put into this trading platform for use. Before adding more expert advisors, I will guide you on how to use expert advisors that are already in this area. It's very simple. You drag and drop the expert advisor out to the screen. You left-click on it and drag it out. And in this section, we will edit the information in the inputs section. Depending on the expert advisor, we will have different sets of information and we can edit that information or keep it as default. In the comment section, please check the Allow Algo Trading button. And if you want to add more editing options, click on the section above, then click OK. And at that point, you will look at the top right corner and you will see that the expert advisor I have added is already there. Next to it, there is an icon that looks like a hat. Currently, this expert advisor is not active yet. If you want this expert advisor to be active, you will need to click this button, the Algo Trading button. Currently, it is showing a red dot on the left. This means the expert advisor is stopped. If you want it to be active, click on it. Then you will also see that the color of the hat changes. The red button here has turned into a green triangle button. And now, if this expert advisor is an expert advisor that helps you trade automatically, it can now proceed to execute trading orders. If you want to stop its operation, you will click here to pause it. If you want to completely remove this expert advisor, you will right-click on the screen. Select the expert list section. Then select the expert advisor you want to delete. Click remove. So, I have removed the expert advisor. It is no longer in the top right corner. All the settings I just finished installing only appear in the first product tab. Here, the tab I am currently working on. As for the next tabs, if I want to bring indicators or expert advisors to that tab, normally we would need to perform the installation steps again, which would be quite time-consuming and laborious, right? A very quick way to transfer everything we have installed here to another product tab is to use templates. So, you will go to the tab where we have installed. We will select the template section, which is located at the top. By default, the template button does not appear on the standard toolbar. If you want the template button to appear, you will need to right-click on it. Select Customize. Normally, the template button is in the left column here. It is at the bottom. And if you want to move it to the right to display it on the toolbar, click on Template, then click Insert. You can see that another button has been added here. So, we click Close to close that window. Then, we will find Template. Select Save Template. After that, we will name this template. For example, I will name it X-Trading 2. Then I click Save. Next, I go to another product tab. I select Template again, and choose X-Trading 2. Thus, I have transferred all the settings in this product tab to this product tab. Similarly, we can set up other product tabs. So, that is how we use the indicators or expert advisors available on the trading platform. Now, if we want to add more indicators or expert advisors to this platform, we will do the following. Please find the File button at the top left. Click on it. Select Open Data Folder. Next, select MQL5. Here, you will see the Indicators folder and the Experts folder. If you want to add indicators to the MetaTrader 5 trading platform, you will copy and paste those indicators into the Indicators section. For example, I have some indicators for the MetaTrader 5 trading platform. I will copy this. And then I go into the MQL5 Indicators folder. I can go into the specific examples folder or I can just paste it directly outside here. Then, I will find the expert advisors here. I also have expert advisors on this MT5 platform. I will also copy it. Next, I will go into the MQL5 folder. I will find the expert section. I will paste those expert advisors into this section. Then, I will close this. After that, I will go into the MetaTrader 5 platform. I will restart the software. I will close and reopen it. And you can see that when I close and reopen it, the indicators or expert advisors that I just added have already appeared here. These are the expert advisors that I just added. As for the indicators section, if you go into it, you will also see that the indicators that I just added are also here. Now, if you want to use them, you just drag and drop them onto the screen and use them just like the indicators or expert advisors available on this platform. Here, there is an additional note. That is, the indicators or expert advisors that we add to the MetaTrader 5 trading platform need to have the MQL5 or X5 extension. Indicators need to have the MQL5 or X5 extension. Their MQL5 program or MQL5 source file. They must be in these formats to run on the MetaTrader 5 platform. If you mistakenly add indicators for the MetaTrader 4 platform, they will not run. And so, above, I have finished guiding you through the steps to install indicators and expert advisors, as well as adding more indicators and expert advisors from external sources into the MetaTrader 5 trading platform. I hope the information I provided is useful to you. Thank you for watching the video. If you find the video useful, don't forget to give it a like, as well as click the subscribe button and the bell icon next to it to receive the latest videos when the channel releases them.